We Call Them The Snatchers by Deranged Buffalo. It started out as a normal weekend. My dad decided to haul us out camping, claiming that the wilderness will do you good. That was the last advice he gave me before he was taken. We don't know the real name for them, but we call them the Snatchers. I'll start at the beginning of our trip. It was gorgeous. Sunshine, mountainous regions, lush and blindingly green foliage were all around. We set up a camp, a little distance away from a campsite, preferring the peaceful stir of wildlife to the shouts of wives telling their husbands to hurry up and cook the bacon, screaming kids running around shouting bear in the forest and pretending to be chased. My dad and brother got to setting up the tents while my mom and I started getting the food out in preparation for lunch. We needed a good meal before the day's hike. With everything packed and prepared and with a full belly, we made our way to a popular trail. I was excited to be able to lose myself in nature. Even though I complained about going on these trips, I always ended up enjoying them. After walking for a few hours, my dad and brother decided to take a detour off the trail to visit a water source which they thought was a waterfall that they found on the map. We had a couple of hours left until nightfall, so trusting their expertise in map reading, me and my mom followed them without a single moment of hesitation. We were a very active family, and my brother and I were very familiar with the wilderness. After walking for a few minutes, we began to notice things getting quieter until noise stopped completely. It was like a bubble had surrounded us, preventing any signs from penetrating this invisible wall. Immediately, we became wary of our position. When sound stops, it's a good indication that a predator is in the area or has been recently. We had encountered bears and the like before, and we knew how to react in those situations. So we continued on, just much more cautiously this time. I was the first to notice the rot, the death, the decay that seemed to get worse and worse the further we walked. It started off as a few dead leaves, but eventually it seeped into the roots of the trees, causing them to turn black and start to crumble apart. Color and life had been stolen from this place, almost as if someone had taken a giant eraser, removing any signs of life that once existed there. The air became heavy, like a metal blanket draped around our shoulders as we all seemed to sag in our posture, struggling to walk. A chilly breeze began to whisper around our toes, slowly rising and engulfing our entire body in a biting cold mist. It was the sound of them that caught our attention first. It started with strange howls, quietly lilting in the air. My mom freaked out, begging to go back, and my dad agreed. We began retracing our steps. An hour of walking, and still there was no relief from the decay. The heavy air was still chilled. We began to panic as we saw the sun slowly setting behind the tree line, taking away any hope that we had of finding our way back to the camp. The darker it became, the louder the noises started to echo around us. Dad was trying to reach a park ranger, but the only sound that was coming from the walkie-talkie was static. Abruptly, the noise stopped. Quietness resonated around us, spiking fear through my body, sending a line of hair raising up my spine. A blood-curdling shriek pierced the quiet, pulling at my natural instinct to run, flooding my veins with adrenaline. A set of yellow eyes caught my flashlight beam as something peered from behind a tree 50 feet away. We all took a deep breath, realizing we were being pursued. My dad was the first to break the fear that had frozen us all. Like a pickaxe of courage, he smashed away our inability to flee and dragged us along the uneven path we had created. He pushed us in front, taking up a defensive stance at the back in case he needed to fight. My stomach dropped as I heard another, different footfall to ours, almost as if something was scampering through the thick, dead brush, scattering the floor. More followed, breaking out from the sides to chase us, gathering speed and crashing through the rotten foliage. I heard a thud, a shriek, a gleeful yelp, followed by the sound of something being dragged through the leaves. We could see light ahead, a flood of green colors exploding into our vision. We didn't slow, We continued to sprint until we burst through the trees into the trail, gasping for air, muscles cramping, and hearts hammering. My mom noticed that my dad wasn't there. I mentioned the thud and the shriek, and she wiped a tear and grabbed me and my brother by the arms and marched us to our camp. We've located a park ranger, but because of the thunderstorm that just broke, he can't issue a search and rescue until it stops. Me and my family are so anxious to find my dad, so worried that whatever snatched him up might be coming back for us. I'll keep you updated if I can.